Welcome to the recording on present perfect tense. The third type of present tense or the present category, the major term present, the actions in the present as an umbrella term or as an umbrella concept, we have to be present. And present perfect tense is the third type, how an action can be performed in the present form, present time itself in different ways. That's why we have four major divisions or subcategories under present category or any other main categories like present, past, future. We have already seen the different forms, different names of these tense forms. Here we are going to talk about present perfect tense. And as usual, let us have a look at the kinds of actions that can be denoted using this tense. To denote an action that has taken place just before the time of speaking, such actions are referred using present perfect tense. An action that has taken place just before the time of speaking. So isn't it a past action? No. That is the relevance of this tense. That is, it can be felt like a past action, but the effect of the action is still there. So that the present perfect tense, please note down the name, it's perfect, perfected, but still the effect of, the impact of the action is still in the present. It's an action that has happened just before the time of speaking. It's not an action, it's not about an action that happened, that took place 2 days before or a week ago. No. It's just before the time of speaking, this action has been completed. So, this tense is used to denote it rather than the past tense because of the impact of the action being there still in the present. Just have a look at it before going to the textual examples. I have started explanation on present perfect tense. This can be an epitome example, very lively example for this particular tense and the usage. I have started explanation. I have started. Now let us see the helping verbs. Main other detail we have to know about a tense is the helping verbs, major helping verbs available in that. Or major help, the main verb, helping verbs that suit with that. Here in present perfect tense, we have two helping verbs available, auxiliary verbs available. Those are has and have. Then about the formation, it's just about the affirmative sentence. So let us go to the main verb form before talking about that. The third main detail we have to know about any tense is the verb form, either V1 or V2 or V3 or ING. Here definitely in every perfect tense, not just in present perfect, but we will see with the past perfect, future perfect, every perfect tense, the suitable verb format or the constant verb form shall be V3. That's a past participle form of the verb. The main verb should be in its past participle form. I have started explanation. Started. Definitely it's not V2 but V3. Go, went, gone. From that we have to choose gone. If you are constructing a sentence in present perfect tense. And has as the main verb should be used with all the singular subjects except I. Again, that kind of a difference is the treatment for I as a subject is different here. With all the singular subjects except I, we can use has. She has eaten a mango. See the example here. She has eaten a mango. She is obviously a singular subject. I have eaten a mango. If you cannot use this subject as main verb that suits with all the singular subjects, with I as a subject, you definitely have to use the helping verb that suits with the plural subjects. Except unless you have an exclusive helping verb available for I. Here definitely we can see the rule to be have should be used with all the plural subjects and with the subject I. Means I also, I even though it is a singular subject, it takes have as the helping verb. See the examples. She has eaten a mango. Why it is eaten? She subject plus helping verb has or have. If it is a singular subject, it is has. If it is a plural subject or I, it should be have. Eaten a mango. Eaten. It's a V3 form of the verb with object. If you have an object, it's there. Otherwise also, she has eaten. I have eaten. She has eaten a mango. I have eaten a mango. They have eaten a mango. Here they, as a plural subject, takes have as the helping verb. And every time you take it consistently, the same main verb here, eat, ate, eaten, V3 form of the verb only suits in this tense. If you want to add more clarification, you can add the verb, word just. She has just eaten a mango. That means it's not a past action, but the implication, the impact of the action is just even now there in the present. It's an action that has taken place just before the time of speaking. That is the implication of the tense. That's the usage, the importance of understanding and distinguishing the usage with the past tense. Should not be confused. Why can't we refer this action using some of the past tense forms? We will come across that, come to that later once we deal with the past tense actions. Then now have a look at the different types of sentences getting constructed using the rules of the tense. Rita has sung a song. Means just before the time of speaking, this action is perfected. That's why it's present perfect tense. It's perfected in the present. It's just there in the present. It's even now it's the singing or the song, the person's performance, the impact. All that is, all of those are there in the present. Still felt. Some people may be appreciating the person. You may be reviewing about the or giving reviews about the song. So that is about the present only. Now just try to make a... to ask the question about it, has Rita sung a song? Just the difference between subject, verb, object pattern. But here, still, we have to ask questions in this this type of action. Regarding such actions, we have to ask questions. Has Rita sung a song? Just an interchanging between the positions of subject, verb, object pattern. That's all. Now, if you want to deny such an action to have taken place, Rita hasn't sung a song. Hasn't sung a song. Has not. Contracted form. If you want, you can use it in written format in this way. Hasn't. And apostrophe S. Apostrophe T. Sorry. Then, with a plural subject also, you can try constructing one another. They have taken a book. Means just before the time of speaking. They have done, they have performed this action, taken a book, they have taken, taken. Sing, sang, sung. That's why it's sung. Sing, sang, sung. V3 form only. They have, they, it's a plural subject. Have as the main verb, helping verb suits with that. Then, V3 form of the verb, they have taken a book. You have want to ask a question regarding that. Have they taken a book? They have not taken a book. We want to deny such an action to be perfected in the recent minutes, recent times. So they haven't taken a book. A negative sentence, an interrogative sentence. So different kinds of sentences we can construct and make it clear. When you get a sentence, if it is an affirmative sentence, try to formulate question, form questions of that, out of that, without changing the idea. Try to deny the statement in the mode of forming or constructing a negative sentence. So this is the way you can become more thorough about this thing, these concepts. Like I have told a story with I as the subject, as it has a kind of difference with the usage of or suitability regarding helping verb. You can just have another example like I have told a story. Then you want to, I have told, tell, told, told. So sometimes V2 and V3 forms of a verb are the same. But definitely if you are using have or has as the helping verb, or if it is definitely, if you are sure that you are constructing, you are communicating an idea about an action perfected in the present, it's definitely the V3 form of the verb you are using. Whether it is the same, sometimes we have verbs like cut, 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 put, put, put. All the three forms to be seen. That doesn't matter, because we know already which is the V3 form of the verb and where and in which tense we have to use it. By the end of these sessions, we will come to have an idea about this. Which all helping verbs match with which all tense forms and which all types of sentence, which all types of subjects, or which kind of a verb form should be used with such and such tense. This we should be thorough about. Have I told a story? And the same idea, you want to ask a question for it, to make it in a question form. Have I told a story? You want to deny such an action to be perfected. Then you can use this tense construction or the rule of this tense and form this sentence like, I haven't told a story. No, I haven't told a story. Such an action is not has not taken place in the recent the present time. Just before the time of speaking, I haven't told a story. If you want to deny such a possibility, you can say. Then also you can make use of this tense. That's all with the present perfect tense. Going back to once again, just see through, not the action that has taken just before the time of speaking. Simple present tense we denoted simple present tense to communicate about an action that is on the spot, taking place on the spot. An action happens at the time of speaking. Present continuous, it was about the action, it's about the action that is going on at the time of speaking. Present perfect tense, it's entirely different. It's not about an on the spot action or a continuity, but an action that has just taken place. But the effect of this of that is in the present as well. That's why it's under the category present itself. Present tense, the third type, present perfect tense. Please look at the helping verbs and verb forms so that you can construct sentences easily well. Thank you so much for listening.